He wanted Mama Winnie to be here, no one else. Because the only remaining person who represents the struggles of black people is Mama Winnie. The woman who suffered the most is this woman here. They forgot about her. They've never made her anything. They've never honored her. They speak very bad of her. When they were not in this country, they were in exile. When they were in Robben Island, the only person who kept the fires burning in this country is this old woman. And to ask her to leave the ANC to come to the EFF, you'll be insulting her. She doesn't have to be in the EFF to know what is the real struggle. Because she is the ANC. So when you say to her, leave the ANC and come to the EFF, you are asking her to leave herself. And if she leaves the ANC and dies tomorrow, then we will not bury the real person. Because she must be buried with the flag she carried throughout her life. And we are not twisted about it. We know she's ANC. Yeah. But we relate with her. And we are not ashamed to relate with her. And we want her to live long so that we can honor her properly under the EFF government. Us have committed class suicide, Masondo. We stay in the suburbs. We drive in fancy cars. We eat in restaurants. She stays there with the people of Soweto. Yes. She still stays there. She still stays there. When the people of Soweto don't have water, she doesn't have water. When there is no electricity in Soweto, she doesn't have electricity. When Soweto is smelling because of dumping areas and it's not clean, she's also suffering with those people there. She's no longer having the energy to run around and organize protests and lead marches. The only way she can lead her people is by staying with them and dying amongst them and being buried amongst them. That's what she wants to fulfill. So we are honored, Mama, to have you amongst us. It's always great and nice to have you amongst us. I know that you are not strong, but you can't be that weak to an extent that you can't carry a mic. I think you can hold a mic. If you can't hold a mic, I'll hold it for you. These people of Orange Farm, they don't want you to speak. They just want to hear your voice. Yes. They want to hear your voice. And Mama, you are not going to deny them that. So ladies and gentlemen, fellow fighters, I present to you Mama Nomzamo Winnie Madikizela Mandela. National Chair, Deputy Premier.
Thank you. Afana Ndlozi viva. Afana Ndlozi viva. Viva EFF viva. Yes, when actually, yes, I thought I'd disagree. Yeah, I really realized that I did a bad job. I've been telling my colleagues that you are coming back one day. Now I'm convinced you never come home. Professor, I am so sorry I didn't understand the weight of what you are saying. I don't know whether I'm standing here not to stand here. About my boy there, because you said you came here to tell us about my boy there. When you left here, I don't know him at all. You have no idea what it means for me to be an orange farm. We crisscrossed this country, and this is one of the areas I operated in at night. Our underground was very strong here. And for me to come to an orange farm that has solid houses today, no matter now how much we have messed up finances, at least we manage to give Orange Farm these homes. I know we are captured. But we have not been captured to the extent that we didn't give you a home. We're very proud of you, my boy. But the last insult, honestly, you know, Julius, why did you say that we are royalty? Because indeed we are royalty. The Mandela family is royalty. I've even brought you a princess to show you. Princess Ramaswazi. Can you stand up and show the AFF that there are real princesses? This is Princess Ramaswazi, granddaughter of Chokuza, granddaughter of Mandela. Yes, he is a real living one. I'm really very, very proud of you, AFF. Ever since you're in Parliament, my boy, you did what I said you should do. Because we were sleeping and getting bigger and bigger in that parliament as parliamentarians. But you did a better job. Not a single parliamentarian sleeps today. And I see when they do sleep, you wake them up very quickly. It's such a pity, Professor, you don't come to our parliament, because I think it needs you to come and describe exactly what is happening with a captured parliament. Well, I'm not going to waste your time. I'm just very glad to be amongst you, especially Umzi was the orange farm. And Siyabulela kakhulu bantwana bam that you are where you are today. We are very, very proud of you. I know you have been sniping at us, Julius, about our forthcoming conference. Yeah, it's our Koni conference here too. Whether you like it or not, we are going to have our captured conference. how much I am captured. We have lots of problems, you know. And you seem to know our problems better than we do. Every day as you insult us in Parliament, you are doing a very good job. And you are doing exactly what I said you to do in Parliament. And we are hoping that in the near future, this youth that is here will be the leadership of South Africa. Yeah. We are hoping for a South Africa that will not be captured. We are hoping for a South Africa that is non-racist. A lot of blood was lost here. Our constitution was written in blood. Bala abantu base Orange Farm ngezomini bakunzima. We fought battles here, Namapuru. And we are very happy today Uti, we can have an event in Orange Farm and not in a squatter camp. Well, you can be able to yes.
Thank you very much, Baba. Amanda!
I can tell you are not one of the camp shots, eh? And Amanda! Amanda! Viva!
Thank you very much, fellow fighters.